Namaskar. Good morning, dear students. Today, I am here with very important topic, a term 1 exam paper guidelines. Today, we are going to discuss syllabus, paper pattern, and how to solve paper. Let's start with syllabus. As you know, we have chapter 1 to 7 and poems for this exam. Chapter number 1, about to remember. From this chapter, we have question answer, writing, and grammar also. Okay, vocabulary, all these things. In grammar, nouns and vocabulary suffixes. Chapter number 2, little girls are wise. Same as chapter 1, question answers, think and answer. Then after kinds of sentences and vocabulary, ED and ING, ending words. Then after the poem Merchant, chapter number 3, the Canterbury Ghost. In this chapter, question answers, writing, then phrases, clauses, then vocabulary of this chapter. Then chapter number 4, the blue light. From this chapter, nouns, the coordinating and subordinating conjunctions, phrasal verbs, question answers, writing, informal letter, dialogue writing, story, and diary entry. From these four. Then after, the way through the woods poem, chapter number 5, to the memory of a lion. In this chapter, types of conjunction plus synonyms, writing, topic sentences, paragraph writing. Then after, chapter number 6, Mala layers of sight, transitive, intransitive verbs, question answers, writing, speech writing. Okay, then we need Chess poem. Chapter number 7, Grandpa fights an ostrich, question answers, mixed tenses, plus report writing. So in short, grammar topics, first these 7 topics and poems, 1, 2, 3 poems, right? Chapter 7, 1 to 7 and 3 poems. Then after, grammar, nouns, kinds of sentences, phrases and clauses, then coordinating conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions, transitive, intransitive verbs and mixed tenses, writing topics, diary entry, story, dialogue writing, informal letter, paragraph writing, speech writing, any of these, any two of among these all, right? Now let's see the paper pattern. This time we are having reading section. In section A for 30 marks. Section A, 30 marks. In this section, sorry, 20 marks. Section A, 20 marks. Unseen passages are there. Before solving unseen passage, you have to read the question first and then read the passage. It will help you to get the answer, to search the answer in short time. Okay, for this you have two passages, for one for 5 marks each, right? Then section B, writing. We have writing for 30 marks. Section B, writing and grammar, 30 marks. Writing, you have story writing and report writing, right? In these two, each 8 and 4 marks. It's divided as per the content. Okay, then after grammar, as I explained you the topics of grammar, your grammar will be placed on based on the textbook headings and the grammar content only, right? But some questions are different from the textbook. Then section C, 30 marks. Section C also 30 marks, textual. In this section you will get the textbook passages, seen passages, right? And question answers, question A wala, within 2 to 3 lines wala, and think and answer also. According to this, you have to be very clear about the marking scheme and the writing section. Practice grammar one more time at home, okay? It will help you to be very clear how to solve your paper. Now let's how to solve your paper. First thing, as you know, you are writing, means you are going to write in notebook or in the supply term 1 exam 2020-21, then standard 6 subject English marks 80, right? Then here your standard 6, right? Then day and all these things you I think that all of you are familiar with the format of heading. Then skip one line. This is your margin, right? Both the sides. Draw one line next to the margin. Then here section A. In section A, suppose you are going to solve question 1. So question 1. Sub question number A. Then write its answer. After this, skip one line. Then sub question B, skip one line. Sub question C, skip one line. After you finish this, then you are going to start question 2. Okay. After you finish one section, if you let have the remaining space of these, okay, you can just skip this and start new section or new page. Always remember, you have to start writing questions on separate one page. Okay, I hope this information will be helpful for you to solve your paper with good handwriting and effectively. While writing your paper, be clear about space between the words. Whenever